I'm really happy to introduce our next two speakers. When we were spinning up this event, talking about what it would take to actually have a productive engagement from all of us, the first person I thought of was Tom Atlee, whose book, The Tao of Democracy, I read a number of years ago and thought was just the product of a wise and experienced intellect, altogether activist. It turned out, the more I knew about it, the more I found out about it, the more I discovered how productive he's been. Tom has been working on this matter really of co-intelligence research going back to the 1980s. He wanted to shift his attention from the conflict process and from the arguments to how do we create what he calls a wise democracy. So he's been working on this whole matter of the conscious evolution of social systems and a sacred science based understanding of evolutionary dynamics. For the last number of years, it's been much, much more about public wisdom in relative economics and to sustainability and to this developing what he calls a wise democracy pattern language. And he's hooked up with this remarkable young man named Andy Pace, and together bringing technology, mindfulness training together to create this kind of collaborative process. He's not only been enacting with all kinds of groups for many, many years, but also blogging about quite extensively on his website. Tom Atlee, thank you so much. Please take us forward in this process.
Okay. Well, this is interesting because I had many versions of what I was going to say before I came on. And then last night at about 4:30 in the morning, I had a whole nother realization of what I wanted to share. So this is going to be a little more nonlinear, but I think it'll be really interesting. I was asked to share the story of how I got into this, and it was on the Great Peace March in 1986 was the watershed experience of my life. And I want to start sharing. So the Great Peace March was for global nuclear disarmament. It left from LA with 1,200 people and collapsed in the desert. What was remarkable was when it fell apart, we no longer had resources and we no longer had anybody in charge. So we had 400 people who hung around in the desert for about 2 weeks and then started out again, going to, this is us marching through the desert. What do you do with 400 people? I mean, the logistics of moving and locating 400 people were just gigantic. And since there was nobody in charge, we had to do it all ourselves. And you can imagine the kinds of chaos and conflict that were potentially involved in that. And there was a lot. But basically what I learned, we arrived in Washington, D.C., our goal. We arrived in Washington, D.C. with 1,200 people again. So it was a lesson in self-organizing dynamics. How do you handle all the details of that kind of an operation? And we basically were guided by a shared goal, and we were very passionate, of course, to be able to do all this. We had to be, this was very important to us. This was what some people call an evolutionary goal or purpose. We basically learned on the run, so to speak, how to use our diversity and the disturbances among us creatively. And I'm going to come back to that theme over and over again, because that's one of the most basic patterns or design principles on my, well, this is somebody drove up with ice cream in the back of their truck while we're in the middle, in the middle of the Mojave Desert. So that's what you're seeing there. And the idea that what we have in politics is a lot of diversity and disturbance. And to the extent we can use that creatively to generate wisdom and good outcomes, that's a way to uplift what goes on in politics gigantically. So this inspired me. When the march was over, it inspired me to, I should say that in the Tao of Democracy, the book that Bill referred to, can you see that? Tao of Democracy. There is a prologue in there which describes the most intense experience of collective intelligence I had on the march, and you can look at it online on the Tao, on the TaoDemocracy.com website. And I began to evolve into this co-intelligence, which is basically holistic intelligence, looking at what intelligence would look like if you had interconnectedness, wholeness, and co-creativity, if you took them seriously. like all the different kinds of thinking and feeling, ways we engage with the world, which I call multimodal intelligence, and then collaborative intelligence, the working together, the even when you're not talking, you're like Aikido and permaculture, you're like working together with the world. Collective intelligence is much bigger than individual intelligence. It's how groups and organizations and communities can be intelligent as living entities. And wisdom taking more into account than we usually take into account when we're just being smart. And resonant intelligence, which a lot of people experience in groups, you know, the sense of resonance, of synergy and linkage with each other. And universal intelligence, which the Laszlo Institute has a lot of focus on in terms of the quantum connections we have and the interconnections and the way nature itself is intelligent. The evolution of nature is a gigantic learning process. And I began to wonder how to apply this to our collective, organizing ourselves collectively in terms of our governance, our politics, our economics. And as Bill noticed, I created the Wise Democracy pattern language. And these are the 96 patterns in the pattern language. And you can, if you want, you can visit this website, wd-pl.com, which is also linked to my co-intelligence site. And you can read some of these and get a sense of what sorts of things are involved. Using diversity and disturbance one, which I mentioned to you earlier, I love this image, which is every one of the patterns has an image associated with it. And they're all a card set. This is a picture of the card for this one. And you can download the cards for free, or you can buy a bunch of them in a printed deck. And then there's related patterns. You can click on patterns that are related to this one. There are questions that are you can use to explore the pattern in more detail and how it applies to situations you're involved in. Underneath the pictures that I have, there's a video I talk about using diversity and disturbance creatively, and then give examples and resources. So there's lots of links. So every single one of the patterns has this. So it's almost like an encyclopedia for how to go about creating a wise democracy. And wise democracy is my version of this goal that we're sharing here, which is the new paradigm democracy. And I collected over the years, I have been collecting processes. I have a feeling many of the people here are interested or familiar with World Cafe. And World Cafe, people sit, usually there's a table, but you don't need to have a table. In these cases, people don't. There's 3 to 5 people sitting around in a circle. And there's some topic they're all interested in, and they discuss it. And then a bell goes off and people get up and move to another table. When they get to that table, they talk about what they heard at the previous table. And so there's an interesting way in which they have the opportunity to be in a small group conversation with lots of airtime and getting to know people. And then they're exposed to what happened elsewhere without ever losing touch with the small group activities. And you can go through many rounds of this. You know, you can go very often, it's 3 to 5 rounds where they'll ring the bell and people go to new tables. And so it's a mixing, a kind of stirring up of what's going on with that topic. And at the end, they harvest from what's there, from what comes up when people speak what was meaningful to them. And it's the people who develop World Cafe are masters of creating questions to explore. They were once had a project to consult with a school in Italy that was coming apart. They gave the question they gave for that school was, what could this school also be? Which takes it from here's a whole pile of problems that we're trying to wrestle with to the vision that sort of leaps right over all those problems. And it was a very stimulating cafe, and the school ended up surviving their problem. The idea that you can do this in a whole community, you can have many cafes going simultaneously. You could engage thousands of people in the cafe. And when I'm thinking of creating community intelligence, I'm often thinking of doing that. Also having what's called a mini public or a citizen council, This is a particularly advanced form of citizen council that's practiced in Austria and now Germany. Few other places are experimenting with it. Thing that is characteristic of all citizen councils and citizen assemblies and citizen juries is they pick people at random from the community. So you're trying to get the diversity of a community embodied in a group of a few dozen or a few hundred people, depending on the size of the council. You want, again, we're back to the diversity, using diversity and disturbance creatively. When you pick people at random, you're getting people who are sort of across the spectrum of opinions, across the spectrum of experiences. They are interacting. And in this particular one, it uses a process called dynamic facilitation in the citizen councils that are in Austria. And dynamic facilitation is the most powerful method I know for transforming conflict into breakthroughs and shared understandings. The woman here with a green shirt, green jacket, as a facilitator, there's some people that sometimes it's just one facilitator. Here they divide the task up into two. And her job is basically to make sure the person who's speaking feels fully heard. And there's a feeling heard is another one of the patterns in the pattern language. But when somebody feels heard, there's an opening up, there's a relaxation. They don't have to push, they don't have to assert, and they don't have to back off and run away. They can just be there. So she's gonna go around to each person and she's listening to each person until they feel heard. While she's doing that, the rest of the people are witnessing a sort of idealized form of communication, of listening. And she's reflecting back to the person going, here's what I think you're saying. Am I getting it right? And so keeping on going until the person agrees that she's really got it. In the meantime, this woman is writing stuff down on the chart pads. And there's a chart pad for problem statements. There's a chart pad for possible solutions. There's a chart pad for concerns and another one for data. And she's just choosing which chart pad to do and writing it down on them. So another thing that's happening is as this reflective listening is happening, a piece of the larger puzzle that nobody saw when they walked in the room is being heard and seen by the people in the room and also recorded on the chart pad. See, these previous chart pads are being posted so everybody can look at them. Another brilliant thing, which I experienced personally in a dynamic facilitation training, is somebody says, I think that's a stupid idea. Facilitator comes up and says, give it to me, what's your concern? Translates the interruption, the disturbance into being a concern. And what happens is people are getting more and more open as more and more of the big picture is showing up. And they start to be creative together about the big picture, the mess that they've generated and coming up, that's what generates the breakthroughs in that. So here's our fundamental unity, common ground. There's many differences, our interconnectedness, our shared humanity, all that, the quantum non-dual connection, et cetera. And our diversity and unity and diversity are two parts of wholeness, and they're just there. So based on your unity, you're beginning to look at the diversity more carefully. You're having and doing that with citizens, including diverse citizens, ways to include diverse stakeholders, and then have generated interactions among them, which is mostly conversation and many different ways to do that. And through that, there's an expansion and deepening of understanding, of alignment, of relationship, of possibility. And that's a form of wisdom, the ability to take into account what needs to be taken into account for long-term broad benefit. And you're getting a bigger picture understanding of what's needed, and that governs action of different kinds. That understanding becomes part of the new shared understandings, which become common ground. I see all of this, my way of thinking about it is the evolving wholeness. You're facilitating the evolution of healthy wholeness using diversity and disturbance creatively. So that's my stumbly way of presenting all this. And since this will be on the material that is shared later, you can come back to it if you want, or you can write to me at cii@igc.org and ask for the PDF. Check, that's it.